Yeah. That's an interesting. My bottom hurts just thinking about it.
She wants you to
treat me like I'm a bad girl.
She needs you to.
Even when I'm being a good to you.
But I don't want you to thank me.
Don't thank
you better
her.
Like thank you, thank you.
Thank you, thank me.
Nothing like a good spanky.
Thank me.
Don't take out your handkerchiefs. I don't want it right.
I just want to thank you.
Thank you, like thank you, thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
She didn't believe in following others or living by their rules. No, that's not quite right. She liked to swim against the tide. Oh God, what is she, a fish? Oh, no, stop editing. Move on, you'll fix it later. But she found if she truly didn't know where she was going, she'd end up in the right place if she followed the sea of people around her. They all seemed to know where they were going. And it was Zen-like somehow, even if against her desire to be different. If one could just let go and follow the flow.
Kat! What are you doing?
It's gonna be fun! New Year and all!
Please, I'm begging you, anything else?
Giotto mums?
I'm trying to get some work done here.
Okay. I'll put on some meditational music.
Thank you. Where was I? Follow the flow. Oh God, that's so cute. I can't use that. Where's my journal? So I arrived at work too early, had an hour to kill before my shift. I was lucky. I got a spot in the cafe. I suppose as jobs go, eclectic musings is a good place to work. Aurora and Sam started this place, I don't know, years ago, and it just kind of took off. Who'd have thunk the city needed another alternative bookstore run by lesbians? No, but it is a great place to hang out, and it attracts some really colorful characters. For example, there is this African priest. I don't really know what country he's from, but I do remember the first time I met him. I was at the counter, and it was slow, and I was writing in my journal. And I looked up, and there he was, with his ears down to his shoulders, a spike through his nose, and a disc in his lower lip this big. And I was saying to myself, Beth, don't stare. Whatever you do, don't stare. Just act nonchalant. So I'm ringing in his order, and he says to me in this real thick accent, "How you doing tonight?" And I realize he was hitting on me. I mean, he didn't really think I thought he was sexy, did he? So I kind of did this deer in the headlights thing and said, "Fine." And luckily, he did not take that as a sign to continue chatting. He's here today. God, I hope he doesn't corner me in the tantric section. Oh, got another one from the Star Girl!
Where is she now?
Oh, Rio de Janeiro.
Oh, it must be nice. Ugh.
You're off to a good start, I see.
Oh, no, not this. This is just my journal. It's mental rambling.
You know they have these things today. Computers?
Well, this is more comfortable. This is easier to carry around.
Cheaper?
Cheaper, yeah.
Aren't you afraid someone's going to just pick it up and read it?
You know, it's funny you mentioned that. Kevin did. He picked up my very first journal just last night.
Oh, this is priceless. Dear Diary.
Oh, God.
My name is Beth Moss.
Give that.
Beth, you might call me the main character of this story.
Oh, come on.
But I'd rather we call me the star.
Stop
oh,
it.
You were so cute.
I was 8. I'm not going to let you read it if you're going to make fun.
How many of these do you have?
Dozens. I was practicing to become a great writer.
Like Dickens, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now I can learn all your secrets.
I should have been like Dickens, paid by the word. But no, not me. I'm paid by the hour. Bored. Bored, 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 bored. Don't say hello.
Hello.
Oh, what's wrong with you?
Oh, I was just applied with another fucking temp agency.
I'm guessing it didn't go well.
Every time I walk into one of those places, they say, You're not an actor, are you? But whatever you do, don't tell anyone you're an actor. Then we won't be able to place you. It's like I'm some kind of freak or a criminal or something. Like actor equals flaky liar person. What? Anyway, it's infuriating. I give my employers too much of myself. I do. I've given up countless auditions, paid vacations, health insurance, and so what? The sheer joy of pursuing a career in acting? Yeah! Pursue it! It's funny. I've never read anything!
Oh, you were in that production of As You Like It.
Oh, yeah. Didn't pay nobody's son. I could do those till I die. And now that I've finally decided, yes! I will sell my soul for health insurance. They badger me with promise you'll never even think about acting again. It's like that's some kind of convict.
If you go full time here, you get health insurance.
Yeah, but then it can't be right.
Oh, there's that.
Switch with me, will you?
Oh, of course.
Excuse me, you're having a book signed by one of my very best authors?
Oh, that'll be me. Hi, I'm Jake Rubin.
Jake Rubin? Naked Life? That's your book?
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
So you like photography?
I love it. My best friend's a photographer.
Yes, and I do hate to break up your little love fest, but I was wondering where am I set up?
That's a good question.
Aurora! Where are we doing the book signing tonight?
Joel?
Alex!
Oh, wow, I'm Jake. It's so good to see you again. We're setting up over here. I've saged. Everything's just about ready. Oh my god! Kevin, I am so sorry. Are you okay?
No, it's okay. I was looking for this book.
What are you doing here? I thought you were in line someplace.
I came to surprise you.
I hate surprises.
Oh, come on. They're fun. You need to lighten up, darling.
I know.
I mean, you are glad to see me, right?
Oh, of course I am.
So, hook me up. I want Jake Rubin to send this poster of his.
Okay, come on, I'll introduce you. Mr. Rubin?
Yeah?
My friend Kevin here is a big fan.
Oh, hey,
he wants to know if he minds having a poster.
Happy to. Ah, nice choice. I can see you have a lovely beard.
Love it.
You're a lucky man.
Thanks. Jake Rubin just hit on you.
He did not. He flirts with everybody.
You want me to beat him up?
Stop it. Hey, I think we're going to be done here soon. You want to get dinner?
Why don't we grab something at the airport? I got to catch the red eye.
You're kidding me. You just got back.
It's really close. D.C., I'll be back tomorrow. Besides, the money they were offering was obscene. I had to take it.
Yeah, well, obscene money. I can't compete with that.
Make something good you want, guy.
I need inspiration. Jake! I have something for you from your long-lost girlfriend.
Oh, she's not mine. Oh, Alex, look, a postcard from Miss Carpe Diem. She sends her regards from Peru.
I'll put it with the others. Mr. Rubin, for gracing us with your presence.
Wow. When you phrase it like that, I'm happy to come back anytime. How about tomorrow night?
We'll consider taking you up on that.
Thank you. And let's clean up.
No, it's a dramatic success. Volumes, we've got some turning PR in. In fact, I think I'm doing it the next show in the gallery, actually. Yeah, 2 hours. Yes. Can you not hear me? I'm sorry. No, look, I've just come inside the front door. Reception is a bit dodgy, so I can't always seem to get to have a hat. I'm going to go.
Hi.
Well, I'm all gorgeous.
Can I sit on your couch?
Oh, absolutely. You can. You know, darling, the bed is eminently more comfortable.
I know. I was just being polite.
I love watching people on the train. You know, if you look at them from the reflection in the window, you can stare forever. It's like being invisible. Or maybe it's the thrill of doing something you know you're not supposed to. And then if you see someone you find attractive, you can look, take your time, study their face and their mannerisms, and they never even know that you're watching. That
You're admiring them. They think you're just looking out the window.
Morning, Rachel.
Morning, Rebecca.
Don't call me that.
Hey, Rachel, you, finished that one woman play yet?
It's getting there.
You passed page 25?
How'd you... Well, Miss Holly Golightly returns.
Who's that?
Nina. Oh, she's worked here on and off for years. She comes, she goes, she goes, she comes. Who can keep up with her?
She's the postcard girl.
I've always wanted to go to Machu Picchu, so we're transported.
Oh, it was beautiful.
We got the postcard.
It doesn't do it justice. You and Sam should come with me in the spring to Glastonbury. What do you think?
Oh, what? Leave all this? It sounds wonderful.
See you Monday.
Good to have you back.
There's this new girl at the store. Rachel was telling me about her. She's been, like, everywhere. How do I get a job like that?
Got a computer program.
You go to Des Moines. She goes to Peru and Crete. You know, I never go anywhere.
Okay. Your computer is now up to date. I gotta go.
You just got back.
I'll see you in a couple months.
Oh, this sucks.
Well, think of all the time you'll have to write.
No, it still sucks.
Honey, I gotta go. I'm gonna miss my flight.
Good.
No, not good. Bad. Hey, look, I will call you from the hotel. Now, you, get to work on that great American novel.
First love story, I've been looking for you, not knowing how foolish that was. Lovers don't meet somewhere along the road. They're in each other all along.
Oh, wow, that's beautiful.
Rumi, he's my soulmate.
Oh, it's a shame he's dead.
I'm Mina.
Hi.
Hi. You're new, aren't you?
I've been here about a year.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, I haven't gone that long. Time flies.
Yeah, when you're in Peru.
I'm Beth. Beth, you should try this. What you do is you close the book, you close your eyes, you get a question in your mind, and then you just open the book to a random page.
Okay, go. Well, what was your question?
No, it's great. Close your eyes. Got a question?
Mm-hmm.
Passion makes the old medicine new. Passion is the elixir that renews. Oh, don't sigh heavily from fatigue. Seek passion, seek passion, seek passion.
What did you ask?
How do I become a great writer?
I've got a customer in the office and one on the telephone. Could one of you help me?
Oh, sure.
Has either one of you recently recommended a book with a yellow jacket cover about some form of astral travel?
Oh, that would be me. I'll take a call.
When a pig's trying to get it, you drop it like a top! Drop it like a top! Drop it like a top! When the pig's trying to get it, you drop it like a top! Drop it like a top! Yeah! Oh! Hey, Matt! Thought I'd find you here. Listen. Listen, I just wanted to let you know that I'm moving in with my friend Kathy.
Oh. Okay, when are you moving out?
Tonight. Bye! Drop it like it's hot! How could you say that?
Serious.
That is absolutely the worst! You could say
I cannot believe it's behaving this way!
What were you thinking?
Well, I don't know! I thought it might be fun!
Why would you ask me that?
Because I love you.
Yeah, well, I love you too, and that's not the point!
Yes, yes, I know we're friends.
Yes, and it's great, just like that.
Is this about Jake?
No. Alex, you know me. Why would you ask me to marry you?
Well, I got swept up in the moment.
You knew the answer.
Fine, you know, I take it back.
You can't take it back now. It's out there.
But you don't have to leave.
Well, I can't stay now.
Yeah, come on, you've got my keys in that pocket.
Keys years ago. Don't worry, you won't get in trouble.
Okay. Copy?
You're psychic.
No, I'm not. If I were psychic, I would have known that my roommate was gonna move out without giving me any notice. She literally came in here yesterday and dropped off the keys while I was working.
Wanker.
Now I have 5 days to find a roommate. I am so screwed.
Do you smoke?
Cigarettes?
Yeah.
No.
Do you think you might want to move in with me?
Well, I couldn't sign a lease.
Oh, I just need a month's rent, and give me a month's notice before you move out.
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't I give you an extra month's rent, or a few months' extra rent, to keep you from panicking?
I guess that would work, too. Don't you want to know how much it's for?
Oh, I'm sure it's fair. You got a key? I'd love to get some sleep.
This is way more than I need.
I just wanted to make sure I had it covered. What's the address?
212 Broome Street, Apartment J.
Cool neighborhood.
Yeah, it's great. Oh, you get the bedroom.
Cool.
Mina, you home?
Welcome home, Maya. I got some groceries. So make, feel free, help yourself. Oh, Maya, I made myself at home. I hope that's okay.
Great.
Great place, by the way.
Yeah?
Thanks so much for inviting me. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, well, I am off. Hey, you want to come with me?
No, I just got home.
Oh, well, another time then.
It's a wild outfit.
Thanks.
Didn't know who you were. Scared the hell out of me.
But this, I could get used to.
What if I let into my apartment?
Exercising? Venting?
You really should have
come out, you would have had a lot more fun.
I don't know why I try. I hate everything I write. And then I get frustrated and I rewrite while I'm writing.
It's okay, just relax, okay? Come here, I'll rub your neck. You just gotta let go.
I know. But then I get frustrated because I can't let go. It's a vicious circle.
Vicious circle, that's a great phrase. Oh, hey, you ever heard of the Whirling Dervishes?
Well, I don't know. Are they a band?
No. They're these dancers in Turkey, I think. Oh, actually, it's a Sufi word. And what they do is they spin in circles to alter their consciousness. It's very sacred. And as they spin, they get into kind of a trance-like state, and it gets them in touch with, you know, everything.
Are you suggesting I spin before I write?
It's just a thought. Might be better than venting.
I've been meaning to ask you about that coat rack.
Decorative, isn't it? Handy, too. Holds all my fun toys.
Do you?
Yes, I do.
Are you, like, into pain?
Oh, no. I like pleasure. Lots of it in all its various incarnations. Yeah, I have Euphoric Tendencies. What can I say?
Is that what they're calling it these days?
Oh, that reminds me, I have a book for you. Now stay right there. Don't tense up.
The Claiming of Sleeping Beauty.
Oh.
It is great.
It starts at the end of the fairy tale, but instead of the prince coming to wake Sleeping Beauty from her slumber with a kiss, he does it by making love to her.
That's erotic.
Oh, yeah, it gets better.
Well, thanks for the book and the necro. I think I'm going to take a bath.
Enjoy.
Thanks. Mina?
Morning.
Something came for you.
Really? What?
It looks like a check.
Oh, really? Well, let me see. Oh, look. I got $5. Sometimes I get these minuscule royalty checks.
What from?
Oh, I had some poems published way back when.
You're published? You're kidding me, where?
Oh, God, who remembers? I had 2 books of poems and then a few in some obscure magazines.
That is amazing.
You know, I did travel books too for a while. I didn't really like it, though. You know, I'd much rather do it than write about it.
I really want to hear more about this, but I gotta go to work.
Oh, call off! I'll spend the afternoon telling you about my travels.
I can't.
Why not? When was the last time you missed work?
Well, I don't know. I don't remember.
Okay, then this has been way too long. Hi, Aurora. Beth is sick as a dog.
No, she threw up
all last night, and she still wants to come to work. But I'm not going to let her. You'll be okay without her, right? I thought so.
Oh, well, let's go.
I'm going to get numbers.
Okay.
Hi!
Hey!
I'm glad I caught you before you left for work. I came by to drop off another postcard to remind you to come to my show tomorrow night.
What's tomorrow night?
Store's closed tomorrow night. You have no excuse.
Hey, you're coming too, right?
Mm-hmm. What's on the postcard? Is that Jake Rubin's gallery?
He flirted with me in the book signing.
Yeah, that's Jake. He's a lot of fun.
Oh, wish God when we're here. He left his work. Nina, are you okay?
Just need some.
Are you the one who sent Jake the gift and the postcard at the signing?
Yeah.
So you and Jake?
Yes, he was my boyfriend!
Oh, this is going to be fun. So let me get this straight. You came back in town basically to get back together with Jake, but instead you slept with an old flame who then asked you to marry.
Kinda.
And this old flame and Jake are friends, right?
Oh yeah, he's Jake's best friend and publisher.
Well, don't you think they're gonna talk? I mean, won't Jake be angry that you slept with his best friend?
Nah.
But he will know you're in town.
Exactly, and he hasn't called me.
He doesn't have my number.
Well, he could get it from Aurora. He doesn't want to talk to me.
You left town. You should call him.
I was going to.
Well, we're almost there. You ready?
No.
Yes, no.
Come on.
Thank you.
frighteningly good morning.
Because I've got a secret.
Oh, do you now?
And I'm not gonna tell ya.
Yeah, but just remember, I know where you live.
Okay. Hey! Ah! You made it. Oh, good. Okay, my stuff is over there and in the next room. The bar's easy to find. Take a look around. Come find me when you're done.
I want to know what you think. I want a drink.
Can I get you one? Yeah, I'll have a glass of white wine.
Okay.
Do you know where Kat went?
That way. I'll bring it to you.
Okay.
I would like a double whiskey, straight, and a rolling rock.
I see your tastes haven't changed.
I've always had great taste.
Well, I can't argue that. So, you came back to town. And you didn't call.
Oh, I know.
Coward.
You know I hate phones.
Yeah, I know all your faults and how to fix them.
Oh, no. Now, that is not what I thought you had in mind.
Yeah, well, I'm saving that for later.
Oh, that reminds me, I need a white one.
You're here with someone.
Beth, my new roomie.
Oh, would I like her?
Oh, probably. Speaking of, there she is.
Does she always look like that?
Beth, you okay?
I didn't find Kat, but I found her stuff.
I had to introduce you to an old friend of mine.
Who do you call an old? I know you from somewhere.
I met you at the book signing, at the bookstore.
Right, but I don't think I got your name.
Oh, I'm Beth.
Hi, Beth. You enjoying the show?
Yeah, the photography's great.
Yeah, I'm really happy with this new batch of photographers. Oh, speaking of which, there's one of my favorites. Hey, Kat, come on over here.
Hey, I see everyone's men. So what do you think?
I think I need another drink. May I have a glass of white wine, please?
What's the matter with her?
Oh, I think she's on overload. She still thinks she's vanilla.
This is so surreal.
I take it you don't like the photos.
No, I think they're great. It's just that I didn't know you were going to be in them. Or that you were into...
BDSM.
What is that?
Bondage, discipline, sadism, masochism.
Have another glove, thank you.
You can have as many as you want.
Oh my god. Is that more insane?
Yeah.
Are they?
Lesbians?
No! I know that! Are they into...
Yes! Another white wine coming up.
Thank you. How long have we been friends?
Oh, long time.
And how long have you been into this?
Longer.
Does everybody at work know this about you?
No! Look, I don't want to freak you out. You're kind of conservative.
I am not!
Beth! They call you Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm.
That was a long time ago.
I'm sorry, but you're obviously uncomfortable.
No. No, I'm not. It's just the timing is really weird, you know? You gotta admit, this is a lot to take in at one time. You know, Mina is my new roommate. She's inserted this coat rack in the corner of my living room, and on it are hanging these things that I have never seen before. And she gave me this book to read, and now Aurora and Sam. And you... Just the whole world around me. I never see it before.
What book did she give you?
The Claiming of Sleeping Beauty.
Oh, that is a good book. I knew I liked her.
Oh, how could I have known you this long and never seen this side of you?
Hey, Kat, there's someone in the back room with deep pockets who really wants to meet you.
Find me before you leave, promise.
Promise.
So is there a place to play, or is it strictly showing?
It's just pictures, huh? No one's showing anything. Besides, there's too much light.
I like a lot of light. I like to see what I'm doing. See that butt here?
Yeah, with all the pictures in black and white, you can hardly see the blush.
Beth, how you doing?
I'm kind of lost in thought.
Jake and I thought we might sneak out, catch up. Would that be okay with you?
Of course. I've got to find Kat before I go.
Wait, you want us to wait?
No, you go ahead.
No, see, as I know anyone can just whack away and have it over and done with in a second. I mean, that takes no talent at all.
I agree. Reading partner, I remember this one play party you were at. There was this woman who was obviously new, wanted to top, so I let her spank me. And she did. Bam, 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 bam.
like gunfire.
She didn't know what she was doing.
Right away with a hairbrush.
Now, I don't like to interrupt her scene.
Oh, well, this was different.
Right, so I very politely began to instruct her on the basics. Don't hit high, stop low, build from there, and play with my girl. Don't play with wood.
I don't like wood.
Well, I think that's obvious.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry, no?
No, she meant hairbrush.
I have no tolerance for it.
She prefers leather.
Yes, well, all the best people do.
Although a hairbrush is called for occasionally.
Oh, absolutely.
Very occasionally in my case.
When it's warranted.
Well, yes, but... in our entire relationship, that's been what, once?
Twice?
Twice?
Remember?
Oh, yes, twice.
Well, I must say, once we gave her a talking to, she did quite well, right?
Who? I'm sorry you've lost me.
Lady at the party.
Oh, yes, of course. And not like what we end up calling him.
Mr. Baseball.
Yeah, he was horrendous. This is what we saw from across the room, literally. His arm was going in full circles to gain momentum for the spank, and then finally, oh. It's like, what was he doing?
Well, it's amazing anyone played with him at all.
Where was this party?
It was a spanking party at Paddles.
Hi, honey. I really wish you were there. Pick him up. I'd really like to talk to you. I'm at this art opening, and anyway, I miss you. Why am I still here?
I haven't seen you in a few days.
I've got a break too. May I join you?
Sure.
How are you doing?
Oh, processing.
I'm really sorry I didn't touch base with you before I left the place together.
That's okay.
The show was a success though, right?
Yeah, it went really well.
So how are you doing? I can't write, and I can't get in touch with Kevin. He's in Podunk, Iowa, literally. And I just get these short emails from him, and I think he turned off his cell phone.
He was never really good at communicating.
No, that's true. And then this really weird thing happened to me when I got home the other night. I accidentally saw Mina and Jake.
Oh my God! They closed the door?
Well, it's an old place, you know, and that door never closed very well. And I heard these noises, and so I walked by, you know, to check.
Uh-huh.
And then I accidentally, I couldn't stop watching. Oh my God!
What happened?
Well, she was spanking him while they were having sex.
I wasn't asking for details.
Oh.
I meant to see you.
Oh, I don't. Oh my God, I hope not! Oh, I'm horrible.
Couldn't stop watching, huh?
I know!
How'd you like that book Mina gave you?
I love it! I can't put it down! What is going on with me?
I've got the whole series if you want to read the next one.
It's a series? Hell yeah, I'd love to! I can't stop myself!
God.
What I mean is, I'm sure that Mina has them too. I don't want to interrupt your bedside reading.
I've already read them several times. Besides, I can always go on the internet if I want more series.
Yeah, same masochists are us, huh?
There are plenty of sites.
Oh.
I can show you some if you want.
Well, what, may get in trouble?
Please. Aurora and Sam, remember?
Oh.
Besides, I'm like, trying to build a bomb or something. All I have to do is Google the word spanking and voila.
17,300,000 sites. Oh, yeah. I had no idea there were that many sites.
It's everywhere.
Yeah.
Well, I should really get back to work, but you can keep surfing if you want.
It's okay. I gotta get going. Honey, I'm home.
Hey, I got a DVD. You want to watch?
Oh, what is it?
John Wayne McClintic.
No thanks. You know, I never would have figured you for a John Wayne fan.
Oh, this is classic. And John Wayne movies have some really great spankings in them. This one has two. Hold on, I'll fast forward to the next one.
I watched this when I was a kid.
Didn't realize how hot it was, did you?
It is everywhere.
Well, that's all I wanted to watch.
You bought an entire DVD for
spanking?
What can I say? It is my thing. I am blessed to know what I like in life.
Gosh.
What's it like?
What, spanking?
Yeah.
I thought you'd never ask. Let me show you.
That's okay. Just tell me about it.
No. Some things just have to be experienced to be understood. So, come over here and lay across my lap.
I couldn't.
Oh, sure you could, though. Pretend I'm giving you a back rub.
I don't know.
Oh, come on. You asked. I'm just helping you out here. I will be very nice, I promise.
I feel really stupid.
Oh, that's okay. You can laugh your way through the whole thing. Now I'm being really nice, right?
Yeah, but I'm afraid that anybody can get up.
Oh, now, do you really think I hurt you?
Well, no, not intentionally.
Good.
Oh.
You are?
No, I was just taken aback.
Now, you're the kind of girl who could come from being spanked.
I could not.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I think you could.
People do that?
Oh, yeah, all the time. But I think for your first time, you've had enough.
Oh, okay.
So, nice way to finish.
I can't stop staring at people's butts. Everywhere I go, I'm staring at people's butts. On the way to work, on the subway, all of a sudden I'm fascinated by them. At work the other day, there was this lady that had dropped a book, and she was bending over to pick it up, and there I was, staring at her ass. One of these days, somebody is gonna catch me looking at their butt. It's really embarrassing, but I can't stop myself. Cut it out! Never mind.
Oh, I must have fallen asleep during the movie. Oh, look at you! Haven't you turned into the voyeur?
I have not.
Hey, you don't have to cover it up on my ground.
Back off!
Kevin?
Why are you listening?
Oh.
I got a day off, so I thought I'd come back and surprise you.
You sure did. One of these days, you've got to return my call.
Oh, you know I hate cell phones. They give you cancer. Oh,
you must be Kevin. Hi, I'm Mina, the new roommate.
Hi. What happened to Angie?
Just wait. Well, why don't I give you two lovebirds some space? I'm meeting Jake for dinner anyhow. Have fun.
Yeah, that sounds good. What have we got in here? Yogi tea tahini?
Tahini.
Tahini, what's that?
Mina.
It's not that eating here. Let's go get a burger. I gotta go back tomorrow. Oh, can I get to the airport?
I can't. I've gotta work tomorrow night. You know, which I could have taken off if you'd called.
Ah, but then it wouldn't have been a surprise.
Oh. Beth? You home? Coast is clear.
Nina, you home? Coast is clear. Damn! I thought they were home.
What is that?
Oh, don't worry about it. I'm sure they'll stay in her room.
What are they doing?
Oh, they're spinning.
They're what?
They're spinning. Yes, they're saying. Just ignore it.
Ignore it? How are we ignore it?
Let's get digging!
How can you live with that?
She's nice.
This doesn't disturb me.
Nah. I did kind of think it was strange when I found out that Cat was into it too.
Oh yeah, well, Cat's an artist. They're supposed to be out there.
I'm an artist. You want a glass of wine?
Sure. You're a writer. That's different.
What? I can't be unusual.
Oh, honey, you're great just the way you are.
I'm boring. Normal.
Dull.
I'm glad you're not like them. Weird. You sure she's okay?
She is fine.
It sounds like maybe we should go check on
her. I'm sure she is fine. You gotta admit, it is kind of interesting.
And that is what I call interesting.
Come here.
Beth is at work. Go back to sleep.
No, what time is it?
9:10-ish.
Oh my god, it's 10:30. Why didn't she wake me?
She's supposed to?
She usually does.
Didn't want to disturb me.
Oh, I gotta get up.
You want some coffee?
Yeah, that'd be great. Why am I so tired?
Milk? Sugar?
Hey, black is fine. Why can't I wake up? Oh god, now I remember. We, heard you guys last night.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did we keep you up?
Yeah, not at the beginning, but then later.
Ah, the joy of roommates.
Oh. Look, you know, it's none of my business, but, if you want or need, you know, somebody to talk to.
Oh, always. What are you going to talk about?
Well, you know, about what happened last night.
Look, I'm really sorry. I promise you, next time you're here, we'll be much more quiet.
No. It's not that. It's just that last night, it sounded like, well, spanking.
Spanking happened, yes.
But it sounded like, I don't know, like maybe you were in pain, and I just wanted to make sure, you know, that nothing got out of hand.
Oh, that's really sweet. Thank you.
So you're okay?
Oh, yeah. I'm fine. I'm great. Oh, by the way, I was spanking him.
Beth, your roommate is really, really weird.
Honey, what happened?
Nothing. Look, I just don't get too close to her, okay?
Kevin, what are you talking about?
Just don't go picking up any of her bad habits.
Honey, what is wrong?
She has got some really bizarre stuff hanging
out. Honey, I think you're overreacting.
No, I don't think so. Just listen to me, will you? Keep your distance from her, okay?
Honey, you don't know her. She's really great.
Yeah, I'll see you in a couple weeks. Gotta catch a plane. Bye.
Kevin freaking outside. I seem to be going through something these days. I was at the bookstore the other day, and I found myself checking out titles like So You Want to Be a Lesbian, and Lesbian Sex 101, and bringing home DVDs like Go Fish and Better Than Chocolate. So now I have a question. Does this mean I'm a lesbian? I mean, I still really dig guys.
Do I have to choose now? Is there some sort of rule that says I have to pick a team and stick with it? Am I allowed to be attracted to both men and women? You know, I can't stop thinking about Mina. Does that mean I'm gay? Or bi? Or curious? You know, is this something I'm just starting to figure out about myself? Or is this something that's in my DNA and I'm just now catching on? I'm a little confused.
Mina, can I talk to you?
What about?
About that kiss.
Oh.
The other night I kissed you.
Was that you?
Come on. I'm serious. I've never kissed a woman before.
Well, I couldn't tell.
Well, what does it mean?
That's a good question. What does it mean?
No! This is a big deal. I mean, you are bisexual. You have had all kinds of relationships. I am not. This is a big thing.
No, it doesn't have to be. It just means you got turned on. That's it. Doesn't have to mean anything more than that.
But what if I want to do it again?
I am not going to live with you if you keep overthinking this.
Oh, I'm serious. You know, what if I want to do it again? What if I can't stop myself? You know, what if I can't... Stop talking.
Maybe I can help you with that. You are being a brat and you are begging for a spanking.
I am not.
You come in here. You know exactly what you want. You won't take two steps towards it. I'm just helping you out here.
What do I want?
You tell me.
Hey, Tom!
Kevin!
Hey, Kevin!
Oh, my God! Honey, I'll be right there!
I have 24 hours before I have to get back on a plane! Hey! you missed me.
I did.
What took you so long?
Well, I was in the bathroom.
Was Mina and her latest contest?
No! Mina! Why don't you call me from the airport?
I wanted to surprise you.
Well, you sure did. Now, why do you even have a cell phone?
For an emergency. Mind if I check my email?
No, go ahead.
See you later!
Mina! Can I talk to you for a second?
Anything for you, darling.
Can you come on my shift tonight? Kevin's gonna know something's up if I work my shift.
I will take it if you relax.
Yeah, but what am I supposed to tell Kevin?
Whatever you do, do not tell Kevin anything. Just let it be.
Okay, but what are we now?
We're the same people we were yesterday, only closer.
Okay, but what do I do with Kevin?
I would suggest some form of sex.
That's not gonna bother you?
Why would it bother me? I just suggested it. Oh. No freaking out.
Don't freak me out. Oh. Honey? The next time you're on the road, can you please call me so I know where you are?
Sure, I'll call you from a hotel. Hey, I found a dirty book by your computer.
Oh, honey, give me that.
You little minx, is this yours?
You really don't want to read that.
I am confiscating this, young lady.
Honey, it's really not your thing.
Hey, I am not a complete stick in the mud. I might surprise you, you know?
All right, you want to read it, you go ahead. It's fine with me.
Is Mina coming back?
No. She took my shift at the bookstore so I could spend the evening with you on such short notice.
Well, I guess she's not all bad. Oh, only if you forget to take out the trash, don't let her spank you for it.
He said, what?
You can't spank me
for not taking out the trash.
He seems awfully fixated on Mina. You told him about me, right?
Yeah, but you're an artist. You're supposed to be unusual.
Oh, right. Speaking of, I have to check on that unusual pot of coffee I was brewing.
I want some of that.
You know where to come find it. Didn't tell him you were into it, though, did you?
Oh, not yet. She's a closet spanko.
Who's a closet spanko, and can I get in the closet with you?
Hiya.
Hi.
Oh, look, all my favorite people together.
Flatterer.
Well, it's easy when surrounded by such beautiful women.
And then he sent me this email telling me not to join any covens while he was gone.
Is that the belting rituals?
Oh, I don't know.
What about that drum circle we had for your birthday?
Oh, I didn't tell him, and I don't care what he thinks.
I can't believe he forgot your birthday. He should have at least called.
I know. You know, but he's really busy, and guys are never that good at remembering those sorts of things.
Excuse me, not true. I happen to have a fantastic memory.
It's true, he does better than mine.
Oh, Kat, you mind if I hang a flyer?
Sure, I can okay that. What are you doing here, anyway?
I'm looking for models. I've got some great new ideas I want to try out.
You know who'll be great for that?
Oh, excuse me?
Kat, you are so right.
I'm guessing these would be nude photos, right? Mm.
Clothing optional, BDSM photos.
Ooh, that sounds like fun.
You can shoot it with me?
I don't know.
I can promise you, nobody will see your face.
Well, I guess if we shot them together, it could be fine.
And they'll be the most beautiful pictures anyone has ever taken.
Oh, but, you know, I don't have any cool clothes.
Oh, we can take care of that. Tonight, after work, we'll go to Purple Fashion. They have the best fetish clothes.
Okay.
Hey, cutie, you miss me?
Kevin, you called me!
Well, you asked me to.
Oh, yeah, but I didn't think you were going to.
Oh, ye little fate. So, I've been reading your book.
Oh, that's why you called.
Yeah, well, it seemed like a good reason to. And yeah, of course, I missed you.
Well, that's not the only thing you missed.
Well, was there a note in the book somewhere? I didn't see anything.
No, forget about it.
You are one sexy girl, and yeah, that's some intense stuff.
You liked it?
Well, I don't know, I guess, but for a little late-night fantasy, it's kind of fun.
Well, there are some websites you might enjoy. I could send you the links if
yeah,
you want.
No, I'm good. I think this book will hold me.
When are you getting back?
A couple more weeks, and it ended up being a bigger job than we thought. So is Mina's boyfriend, like, her slave?
No, I think they switch.
What do you mean they switch?
Well, I think they take turns.
She's so fucked up.
What do you mean?
I mean, she must have had problems growing up. I mean, anybody does that stuff, they have problems, right?
You know, I don't think so. I was reading this article, and it said that the place in our brains between pleasure and pain is really close.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Some kind of faulty wiring.
Beth, you ready?
Honey, I gotta go. I'm going out with Mina.
Where are you going?
I'm just out. Come on. Bye.
If you keep that up, I'm gonna take you back and do you right here.
Oh, well, we couldn't have that now, could we?
Made it. You won't sit down for a week. You want to leave the newbie who are on devices?
I think you should help her.
I think she'd rather have you help.
Oh, I'm gonna look at guys.
For you! Peace offering. You forgive me.
Always.
Good.
Just don't do it again.
I promise.
Oh, I wanted to introduce you to my roommate, Beth.
Oh, Can I get that for you?
Oh, no. I don't even know you.
Oh, well, you wouldn't want to hurt my feelings, would you?
No. But it's really not my thing.
Well, why don't we find you something that is?
Okay.
Not quite my thing either.
Brings out the bloodshot in your eyes, though. You have been neglecting your publicity duties.
You tried to steal my girl.
You suck. And that was put in my place. It's...
Marriage? What the fuck were you thinking?
Yeah, I don't know.
All right, publicity. What do you need me to do?
Yes, we've got a webcast in half in an hour. You can come with me to talk about the book.
I can. We're here getting clothes, and then we're going to do a shoot.
All right, well, you know, it's on me. How about that? Now you can come with me, and with that out of the way,
still doesn't work. We're getting the clothes, then we're going to the studio and shooting. But thanks for being a sport and picking up the clothes.
You know, this always seems to happen with us. You get to go back to your studio and shoot two lovely bottom sans niggers while I get stuck footing the bill. Tilray. Right, well, I must get back. I must publicize your work, make us money. My dears, I really must apologize, but duty calls. Back to work. I couldn't get that,
Hey, how are we doing back there? You finding anything?
I love these clothes! I feel so powerful.
You look amazing.
Well, I guess we're good and ready then. Oh, by the way, the clothes are courtesy Alex. I think he likes you.
Oh.
Okay, we good to go?
Let's go.
Let's do it.
I've got another Rumi poem for you. By day, I praised you and never knew it. By night, I stayed with you and never knew it. I always thought I was nude. But no, I was you and never knew it. I love having you as my friend.
Me too.
Don't mind me, I'm not here at all.
I don't know what Kevin's problem is. You know, I talked to him on the phone today, and I told him he missed something, and he didn't even know it was my birthday.
Oh, you should have got out and said it.
I know, but I wanted him to remember. You know, when he's got this bug on his ass about you, I don't think he likes us being friends.
I scare him.
And don't take this the wrong way, but he probably wants to do me now.
Well, I don't blame him.
Ooh. Wow, I thought there was something going on between you two.
Oh, is that okay?
It's fine.
And you know, he took my claiming of Sleeping Beauty book with him, and on the one hand, he's saying it's sexy, and on the other, he's making fun of it.
Oh, he's intrigued.
Yeah, you should surprise him when he gets back.
Yeah, show up at the door in what you're wearing now with a crop in your hand, that'd turn him on.
He'd shit!
He'll love it.
Turns me on.
Maybe I will. You know, he deserves it for missing my birthday.
Exactly.
That's a good idea. Oh, I feel better already. I'm kind of pumped. Maybe I have euphoric tendencies.
Really?
Oh, Lord, I see Mina's been rubbing off on you. Here, take a look.
Oh, that is beautiful. Thanks. I have got to stop doing that.
Why?
I thought I was me, but no, I'm you.
So am I kissing me?
Oh, shut up!
Look, I am really, really sorry about it. I was so Beth?
You missed my birthday.
I'm really sorry about that.
Yes, you are. Now you're gonna make it up to me.
Okay. Where did you learn to do that?
Guess?
Something you picked up from Mina?
You're gonna have to remember to thank her. Damn, that was hot!
Hey, let's just keep this between us, okay?
Oh, gee, honey, I thought I'd run it out in the paper.
It can be our secret.
Okay, our secret. Mm-hmm. Except I'm gonna have to tell Mina, you know, because she's gonna ask.
What do you have to tell Mina?
Well, she helped me plan it.
She planned it? That's a little controlling, don't you think?
No, she's not like that. She's my best friend.
I thought Kat was your best friend.
Oh, well, they're both my best friends. Why are we talking about them anyway?
You brought it up.
Well, you had a good time, right?
Like you said, it was hot.
Oh,
Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. I'm looking for a book on Wicca.
Well, the section's over there, but if you tell me a little bit more about what you're looking for, I can make a suggestion.
Well, I'm sort of a beginner, so something basic.
Well, let's see. The Power of the Witch by Laurie Cabot is really, really good. She's got this meditation in it that's really helpful.
Do you know anybody who gives classes?
Well, there's this coven that I go to sometimes, and they might. I think we have their number in the office. Want to join in?
Did you know Mina's a witch?
Hi, honey. Nice to see you, too.
I just heard her say she's part of a coven.
Well, I think Mina's tried just about every religion there is out there.
She's the spawn of Satan.
Stop it!
It's a joke.
What are you doing here?
I'm taking you out.
Aww.
You make a gurps when you're done, okay?
Sure, I'll be there in a few minutes.
Hey.
Hey.
You got any witch's brew from a girlfriend here?
Kevin, stop it. Have a glass of red wine.
Red wine? Do you drink blood, too?
I cut it out.
I'm just having fun. So did you and Mina dance naked under the full moon while I was gone?
Oh, as a matter of fact, we did. Mm-hmm. You know, and then we had a drum circle and a wild orgy and went out trolling for people to kill with our magic wands.
What is up with you?
Are you angry with me?
I am just having fun.
Really? Because mm-hmm. ever since last night, things have seemed really tense. Now you're harping on me and Mina being witches, for God's sake.
Are you? That'd be new information.
Well, I was thinking about going to a belting ritual. Do you care?
You going because you want to? Or because Mina's going to be there?
I don't know. No, I thought it might be fun.
She is controlling everything you do.
Well, you stop harping on Mina.
Why are you defending her?
Well, why are you constantly attacking her and me?
Her and you are not one person.
She's strong, and you can't handle that.
Oh, what, you think I'm afraid of her? Come on, Beth, that is rich. It is, it's you, Beth. It's you, I don't like what she's done to you. I mean, look at you, look at how you're dressed. You've changed.
I've changed.
You're never home anymore.
How would you know? You are never in town.
I call.
You call. You know, I have not gotten one message from you.
I call, you're not home. And what about your writing, huh? What happened to that girl who used to stay at home and write?
I write every day.
In your journal. She's sucking your life away, Beth.
You know, that is not true. Mm-hmm. You know, she has given me so much. She has shown me so much.
Yeah, well, what has she shown you?
Well,
so strike that, whatever it is. I want to know. You were great just the way you were. Things were fine.
No. I wasn't fine. You know, I felt like I was dying in this really quiet and uninteresting way. You know, like I was plodding along in this life that I wasn't even really participating in.
Thanks a lot.
Well, no, Kevin, I...
Sure, sure, yeah. I wasn't even there at all.
It's not what I mean. It's just that I've started to experience things in a new way, and I don't want to shut that down.
You know, what about me, Beth? Do you care about me?
Well, of course I do.
Because it seems like Mina and these things that you are exploring are more important to you than me.
No, but I feel like you are expecting me to choose between you and them. I mean, what do you want from me?
I want things the way they were.
Well, wouldn't that be like going backwards?
Right. Like to that place where you were dying.
Oh, no, Kevin, I don't mean it like that.
I don't know what to do here.
Well, I don't either.
Look, maybe we just need some time alone to sort things out.
Maybe.
I think I'm gonna go home.
Kevin, did we just break up?
I don't know. Can I get back to you on that one?
You're really quiet.
Just thinking.
You were really fantastic last night.
Well, thank you. You weren't too bad yourself.
That's true. So you seem to think you know me pretty well. What am I thinking?
You want a blowjob?
No.
No?
Right, no?
You.
No, really, what am I thinking?
Honey, I'm too tired to play the mind reading game.
I want to share my life with you.
You do?
No, I want more. And I'm not talking about marriage or monogamy or controlling your life or anything like that.
We've had this conversation before.
Yeah, and you just left town.
Yeah, but I came back.
A year later. I mean, come on. How long are we supposed to go on like this? I mean,
you okay? Hey, Kevin and I just broke up.
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry.
What happened?
Well, last night was the first time that we played. You know, and he deserved it for missing my birthday. And then afterwards, things were really weird, and then tonight we had this big fight.
I'm sorry, that sucks.
Yeah.
Oh. Hey, I've got an idea. What if we just got out of town for a few days?
Yeah, don't ask me. I'm just a man.
You know, we could take a few days off from work and go camping.
I'm not here at all.
No, it's not like that. I'd like to know what you think.
I think he's a schmuck.
Thanks.
And I suppose camping could be a good idea. But if you two decide to fly off to Zimbabwe afterwards, I'm not talking either one of you when you get back.
I can't go to Zimbabwe. I have to work next week.
We'll come back.
I'm just saying.
Why would we want to go to Zimbabwe?
It's a long story. I'll tell you on the way. What are you doing? We are out here to relax, and you are working.
This isn't work. This is my journal. This is my journal.
How can you even see in this light?
Oh, pen light. What can I say? I'm a compulsive journaler.
Yeah, well, stop it. Take a look around you. Look at that moon.
Oh, wow. That's worth the price of admission. I'll tell you what. For the next 24 hours, I won't even touch it. You keep it.
Really?
Yeah, Scout's honored.
No, you were a Girl Scout.
Yes. Merit badges and all. If it counts for anything, I hated it. Except for the camping. I liked that.
So, do you think maybe I could read some of this?
Yeah, sure. It's crap, though. We'd have hacked you a jig meet.
Oh, wow, that was a long time ago. At Summer Stuff. He painted these amazing backdrops. He was a set designer, and I didn't really know who he was until one day he was playing frisbee, and he took off his shirt and his chest. Oh my God, it was amazing. Oh, and then there was this one night. There was a full moon, and
like tonight.
Yeah, and somebody mentioned it, and spontaneously we just both grabbed each other's hands, ran outside, and howled at the moon.
Synchronicity. Do you think there's something wrong with us?
Well, maybe there's something wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with me.
No, I'm serious. You know, sometimes I think that I like spanking because it fills this self-destructive part of me.
You overthink things.
No, I know.
You know, and you can think things to death.
I know, but I've always got that ticker going, you know? Do I give enough? You know, do I give too much? Do I take enough risks?
Do I take too many? Maybe I should think things through and analyze more. Oh, but then again, if I do, maybe I'll stop myself from doing things I really like.
Okay, I get it.
Everybody feels that way.
So everybody's fucked up.
Pretty much. You can say I like spanking, it's fun, or you can say I must really be fucked up. Of course, my guess is you always thought you were fucked up.
And I guess I was right.
Or you were wrong.
Oh, semantics.
Point of view.
What about you?
It's the way I breathe.
I like the way you breathe.
mind if I sit here?
Sure. Hey, you're Jake Rubin.
I am.
I'm sorry, you must get this all the time, but I'm a big fan.
Well, I never get tired of hearing it.
I was at your last signing at Eclectic Musings. So.
Right, you're Kevin.
You remember me.
Well, we have a mutual friend, Beth Moss. Actually, I met Beth through her roommate, Mina.
You're Jake?
Last time I looked.
So, you're into the...
You have seen my work, right?
My life is so strange.
What are you drinking?
Rolling Rock.
Excuse me. Can I get a couple Rolling Rocks here? Yeah. Start a path.
Thanks.
Actually, I was kind of hoping to run into you.
Really?
Mm.
Why?
I hear there's trouble in paradise.
Oh, God.
It's okay.
Actually, it feels a little more like hell right now.
Did she say you? Are you kidding? She'd kill me if she knew I was here. Hell, they both would.
Cat?
I just thought I'd come and try to lend a helping hand.
So to speak.
You look kind of lost.
You know, I always saw myself as a regular kind of guy, you know? Fairly normal. I like that about myself, and now I'm just not sure if that's true anymore.
No offense, I don't think you've ever been normal.
You don't even know me.
I can see. But I face it, you're a computer geek.
Oh, well, that's different. That's respected.
That is normal, anyway.
My friends. I have a great group of friends.
They'd think less of you?
No, I wouldn't even discuss it with them.
So you're thinking they'd hate you?
I know them fairly well.
You know, sometimes people can surprise you.
I don't know, it's just... I like being in control. I mean, I'm good at it, and that's who I am. Oh, Beth, it's changed, and... No, I'm not making sense. Don't listen to me.
No,
no, it's kind of hard to describe.
I get the gist. You know, maybe you should try topping her.
Come again?
You be the drummer instead of the drum?
I mean, I don't know. What if I heard her?
Think you already did.
Women.
You're telling me? I can't even get mine to stay in town.
I get us another round, will you?
You know, if you do it right, you won't hurt her.
I won't?
No, as a matter of fact, it might have quite the opposite effect.
Really? Okay, I'm listening.
Sometimes I feel like there's so much going on inside me that I'm going to explode. It's like my body can't completely contain my emotions, be they love or fear or sexual energy. It feels so all-encompassing. And now I feel like I've found a way to channel that. Safely. I can be expressive and loving and primal all at the same time.
Well, thank you for the advice and for the beer.
Hey, listen, I'm opening a new show at the gallery on Friday, and I think you might find the subject matter intriguing.
Oh, don't tell me. Lots of red cheeks.
You gotta know what you like in this life.
That is very true. I like logic and puzzles.
Women.
Beth. The way she smells is intoxicating.
Mm. Speaking of intoxicating, there's gonna be an open bar at the gallery.
Oh, Mina and Beth will be drinking there.
They will, yes. I'll put your name on the guest list.
Great.
I'll look forward to seeing you there.
Someone with long hair and light eyes looks for me in another country, and I, feeling and knowing you, want and search the sky for your likeness. I heard your voice in my head, sure, resonant, and full of desire. With my eyes closed, you're here. I want you to know me truly, to see me naked completely, see past the body, see all and still love me, to help me love me, because I see all of you. Can I help you love you? Are we ready? Let's walk the precipice, jump, and fly.
Mina? What are you doing up?
Thank you.
Are you okay?
Oh, Paul.
I don't know what to say.
Oh, you're speechless. What? Did the planets align while I was asleep?
Oh, fine. Make fun of me. I've been reading all night. You want some good bedside reading, you should read this.
Oh, that's my journal. You really haven't slept?
No, I couldn't put it down.
Well, do not blame my journal for your insomnia.
Whatever you do, you have to keep writing.
Please, I can't stop myself.
You should publish this.
Please.
No, honestly, it's compelling, honest, provocative.
It's rambling, uneven, it has no structure. As far as writing goes, it's shit.
Oh, okay, well, you tell me, what's good writing?
Gates. Bukowski.
Rumi. Should I write more poetry?
Oh, I don't want to write more poetry, and my poems suck. And that's not the point.
Okay, what is the point? What do you want said?
Well, I don't know, not that.
Why not?
It's personal.
Oh, okay, that's it, isn't it? It's not that it's bad, you just don't want to share this much of yourself.
No, that's not it. It has no storyline.
It's your journey.
It's stupid.
No, no, it is real and beautiful, just like you.
Well, whatever it is, I want you to have this one.
Really?
Yeah, it seems appropriate. You inspired most of it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's true.
Oh, it sucks.
What? You don't want to be my beautiful.
Oh, it's just the timing. It really sucks.
What do you mean?
Beth, I think I have to move in with Jake.
No!
No, I'm sorry. It's just Jake and I, we've been having this argument for years, and it's just come to this point. I don't want to lose him. I don't want to lose you. You want to come live with me and Jake?
No.
No.
No. Oh, it probably is better. I mean, he's in our place anyway all the time, and maybe they don't get more time to write.
You do that.
Good.
Aw.
So tell me,
Does Jake know?
Not yet.
So, can I stay on your couch?
No.
No?
No, but there's a place in my bed I think you'd fit in quite nicely.
Well, your closet's gonna have to make room too.
Yeah. Oh, cut it out, you guys. I'm not happy about this.
Oh, honey, there's always a place for you in our bed.
Yeah. Thanks. And on that note, I'm going to go shell more bucks in the other room.
Oh, come on. Don't be like that.
Oh, hey.
Oh, gorgeous. Well, I was supposed to be meeting Jake here, but this is much nicer.
He's just chasing a girl as usual. Oh, Alex, I was wondering, would you do me a favor? Would you read this and tell me what to think?
Anything for you, darling.
Well, I gotta get back to work. Will I see you at the gallery later?
Yes, as always, I shall be working the room.
What are in that position?
Hey, Alex, hope I didn't keep you waiting.
No, not at all. You need some time to flirt with Mina. But, now that you're back, I want to talk about tonight's show and how we might use this to our advantage.
Well, it's good for you.
Yes. Rachel? What happened to your arm?
I don't know. All I know is I'm in pain. Okay, I thought it wasn't too much computer work, so I rearranged my desk to make sure it was ergonomic. I put a brace on, and then I went to see my doctor in Casablanca. Because lucky me, I now have health insurance.
In Casablanca?
Well, their office looks like the set from Casablanca, and none of the doctors speak any English. So one of the doctors said it was tendonitis, gave me drugs, which he says if I take will turn me into a drug addict, and then sent me to see a specialist. Well, the specialist says I need to see a physical therapist 3 times a week, which even with insurance is like $400 a month. Who has that kind of money? And then it turns out that none of the physical therapists even take my insurance, so I have to pay an additional $300 on top of it just... So I went out and I found a physical therapist in my network, only she wouldn't even treat me because she said my pay doesn't make sense. What? Ow! So it's back to Casablanca I go, whereupon Habib puts me in a pretzel pose and tells me to push. I'm screaming, every muscle in my arm is cramping, and he says, I am very sorry. I know you need a prescription for an MRI, but I cannot write you one because your insurance says you need to see a specialist. So I call another specialist, and now I have to wait a week just to find out what the hell is wrong with me. So now I don't know what's wrong. All I know is I'm in more pain now than when I started having health insurance. Is it worth crap? I'm taking the drugs. I don't care if I do turn out to be a drug addict. Maybe then I can channel Aleister Crowley and just hex them all. I see a dagger before me. The handle toward my hand. Come, let me clutch thee.
Rachel, are you okay? You're quoting.
Don't say it.
Macbeth.
The Scottish play.
What does it matter? We're not in the theater. We're in a bookstore.
You jinxed my monologue.
Why are you working on a guy's monologue?
Class, role reversal, play something you'd never be cast at.
I think you better pretty safe bet.
Well, it's better than the play we're doing. We're doing Richard III, and I play Elizabeth.
Aren't you a little young?
Yes, thank you, but that's what you get when you're a young character actress. You play mothers and grandmothers. Sucks. Anyway, right now we're doing a scene where Elizabeth enters, having found her husband dead. And I'm doing the grief, distraught thing from the beginning, only I don't feel anything. Nothing. Nada. I'm numb. And I'm getting really mad at myself. I don't feel anything. So I start pounding my fists against my body. You know, partly in frustration, but partly to do the ripping off the clothes, grief, distraught thing. And the scene starts working much better. I mean, I have bruises all up and down my back.
Well, maybe that's how you hurt your arm.
Maybe you should try beating on someone else, huh?
No! That'd be a bad idea.
Oh, there's neither good or bad, but thinking makes it so.
Don't quote Shakespeare at me trying to convert me to your deviant.
Oh, I'm what? Not proselytized.
Wasn't Shakespeare deviant?
Definitely.
Well, it didn't hurt me. No. I'm going to sell more books with the one good arm.
Macbeth! Beware the vein of horror!
Close a little early.
Oh, what a great idea! You are a brilliant woman.
Thank you, I think so.
Oh, did I tell you about the photo shoot I had the other day?
I don't think so.
It was interesting. I had these two models. One, Christy, wonderful, I've worked with her forever, and a new girl, this gorgeous redhead, and I'm thinking this is going to be amazing, right? Well, it turns out she's nuts. At one point, I asked for a reaction shot, because I was close on her face, and I wanted to get some emotion. I asked Christy to give her a little inspiration, and I meant a little. Christy does this, and the redhead lets out this blood-curdling scream. Ah! Like someone had cut off her foot or something. Scared me to death. And then I'm thinking, great, the people next door have most likely called the police. What do I say when they arrive?
You were shooting stills for her.
Oh, you're such a quick thinker. Yeah. Oh, then we find out she had this I deserve to be abused complex. Mm-hmm. When I heard that was it. I won't work with her again. She was hot, but not worth the grief. I said to her, honey, get yourself some therapy.
Could you take her at the bar for me? I have to restock the beer.
Sure. No problem, honey.
As always, a tremendous success.
Well, I can't take all the credit for it.
Of course not, the credit's all mine. Good, you've got some lovely models. I really should have been a photographer. Oh, I've got to tell you. Ouch! Now over there, there's some young lovely thing that I've been tatting up, so I'm just gonna go. You stay here. You'll scare her with the cat sleep.
Alex, she's a he!
You don't mind that you use some of those pictures of us, do you?
No, I mean, you can't see my face, and I kind of couldn't say no when he asked.
I have that problem with them all the time.
afterwards.
You guys just missed Alex. He was whining about how I never introduced him to my models, so I wanted to reintroduce those two.
Oh, that's okay. I kind of like the anonymous thing. Mm. Mm.
Thanks.
Oh my god. You invited
him. Him who?
Him, Kevin.
My bad, sorry, must mingle.
I didn't expect to see you here.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised to see me here myself. You want a drink?
Well, I've got one. But let's get you one.
Okay.
Cat.
Yeah. Hey! Look who managed to show up! Kevin!
Can I get a beer for Kevin?
Kevin!
Yeah.
You see that picture over there?
Yeah. Is that one of yours?
No! It's one of Jake's.
Oh, but you should take a really good look at it.
Okay.
Stop helping!
Well, now I got my beer. Let's go take a look at this picture. Damn, that's beautiful.
Look at all these weirdos, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. I guess we fit in pretty well. Hey, you didn't tell me that he was your roommate's boyfriend?
Please. I couldn't say Nita's name without you cringing. Mm-hmm. Besides, she's not my roommate anymore.
No? So they're all alone?
Yeah. I mean, she moved in with Jake. What are you gonna do?
So why was Kat so anxious that I look at this picture?
It's me.
Is it? Yeah. Oh, yeah, now I see it. Well, like I said, beautiful.
You don't mind?
Well, nobody can see your face.
Yeah, but you recognize me.
Well, I have a little more intimate knowledge than others.
Oh, by the way, darling, the manuscript you gave me, I loved it.
Let me roll it.
You had better let me publish that little work of fiction of yours. All right, now just what is that critic that I've been buttering up? We will both. Now I'm going to do it. Oh, and you know what? The handwritten touch, I love that. And the suit of is so cute.
Alex, and I didn't write it.
Oh, yes, I know that.
No, no, Alex, you talk to me before you do anything.
I'll get the bubble.
I think that I ought to take you back to that big, empty apartment and show you a few of the things I've learned.
You learned something? What? A new way to wire my TV.
Are you bratting me?
Would I do that?
Keep it up. I'll put you over my knee right here.
You would not.
You want to test me?
Let's go with my place.
Good answer.
Sheridan Press. No, I'm afraid he's in a meeting. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll tell him you called.
Alex!
I need a complete list of all new acquisitions. Do you have them yet?
Yeah, you know, I'm in a pile on my desk!
Oh, why does the to-be published pile to be so heavy? Want to help me make phone calls?
Me? Sure. What do I need to do?
We need to call every author in this pile or the author's agent, send all the paperwork, make sure the contact information is correct.
Yeah.
I really can't fix this right now. I'm going to get some coffee. You want some coffee?
I'd love some. hazelnut latte?
Yeah. Would you answer phones while I'm going?
Sure. Just take messages. I'll be back. You're impressed. You're five. Hello, Sharon Press. No, I'm sorry, he's not in the office right now. Can I take a message? Uh-huh. Call Nina. Okay, cool. Can I tell him it's regarding? Oh, yes, I have it right here. Ha,
it's on our to-be-published pile. I was just taking a look at it. Well, not really. But it's like on the list to be published right now. And we're going to call her today. Oh. No, okay, I won't. No, don't call her. Right. Are you her agent? Hello? Hello? And she just hung up on me. Here we go. Any messages? Yeah. I think just screwed up. There was a lady and she called and she said she was an author's agent and then she said not to call the author and then she hung up.
Did you get the agent's information?
No. She hung up. I'm really sorry.
It's okay. That's okay. We'll call the author directly.
But the lady said not to call. She was very adamant.
Honey, agents never want you to talk to the author directly. Besides, she hung up on you.
Yeah. I still feel really bad.
Don't worry. It'll be fine.
Hello?
Hi, it's Beth Mawson.
Oh, this is Beth Mawson.
This is Pamela Norwood. I'm calling from Sheridan Press. We're in receipt of your manuscript, and we're pleased to tell you we'd like to publish it. Now, I need to send you some paperwork. Do you want me to send it to you or your agent?
Excuse me. I'm sorry. I think you have the wrong number. I don't have an agent.
You don't have an agent?
No.
Well, that's not a problem. I'll send the paperwork directly to you. Would you like me to email you or send you a hard copy?
I'm really sorry, but you must have the wrong person. I didn't submit anything.
You are Beth Moss, right?
Yes.
Well, perhaps your manager submitted it and the cover letter got lost. I mean, I got your number from the inside front jacket.
My number's inside the front jacket?
Yes. It's a lovely leather binder. Most of the time it's just cardstock.
What publishing company did you say you were?
Sheridan Press.
Can I call you right back?
Actually, I would prefer it. I think she hung up on me. Let's take another break.
Oh my God.
Are you okay?
I can't breathe! They want to publish my journal!
Your journal?
Oh my God, I go over everything in there. Everything.
You sent your journal to a publisher?
No, I wouldn't do that.
How did you get it?
Oh my God, someone I don't even know this breakfast thing. I go over everything. Like the first time I had sex. So I gave a blowjob. That's
Beth. How did they get your journal?
Well, I don't know. I gave it to
Who'd you give it to?
Nina.
Oh my God.
I gave it to me.
Beth, how could you do this?
She loves
How could you trust her like that?
I don't know what I'm going to do. Oh, what am I going to do?
Just come with me. We are going to get your journal back.
What were you thinking?
Darling, I love it when you're feisty. Now, what are you talking about?
I am serious. She is going to be really pissed at me, and it's all your fault. I trusted you.
All right, Nina, do calm down. Tell me, what are you talking about?
Beth's journal.
Oh, with a pseudonym. Oh, good stuff. Yes, you must have been surprised.
Alex, focus.
No, it's wrong. We can edit that.
Lot.
How could you contact her?
Nina, I told you I wanted to publish it.
I never told her that I gave it to you.
Never told who what? What?
Beth, the author. I told you to talk to me before you did anything.
You really didn't write it, did you?
No!
Well, this is all very confusing. Get out of my
way!
We are here for Beth Moss's manuscript.
I just stepped out for a minute and this.
You! What are you doing here?
Should I call
I told Beth to stay away from you, and now look what's happened.
Yeah, and who are you?
That is Kevin, Beth's boyfriend.
We're here to pick up Beth's journal.
Should I call security?
No,
sure.
This will be fine. We can
Kevin, please come down.
Ooh, hi. You look familiar. What have you?
You met at Purple Passion and Jake's.
Oh, Beth!
Hi, Jake. Good to see you.
Came as soon as I could. Jake, nice to see you. Join the party. Listen, Beth, I'm terribly sorry. Darling, I didn't know that the manuscript was real. I just thought it was fiction. Really great fiction.
Did Mina give you my journal?
Well, she asked me to read it, yes.
Beth, I just wanted him to read it.
And I loved it!
It was so good, I knew you'd never take my word for
it. I certainly do want to publish it, with edits, of course. But, darling, I never contacted you.
A lady called for Beth.
Amala, or something like that.
Hannah! you didn't happen to contact Beth,
Moss!
Beth Moss wrote the list, did you?
Yes, she's on the list.
I see, I didn't give you her manuscript.
You ran out the door and told me the list was on your desk. The manuscript was in the yes pile with a big giant sticky note on it that said, publish this.
Well, that's all solved, isn't it? Listen, Beth. terrible. Sorry for the confusion, and I can see this comes as, well, a bit of a shock, but I really would like you to consider allowing us to publish your journal. I honestly think it could be a bestseller.
I really don't know what to say.
Well, take a few days, think it over. We can have lunch and discuss it. You know, I'll have Amala give you a call, as she obviously has your number. Now, if you'd all be so kind as to leave at once, I do have quite a bit of work to do.
Beth, please.
Oh, don't touch me. I'm sorry. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
I never want to see you again.
You. Stay away from her.
Really screwed up. What do I do?
You go home, you get spanked hard.
You okay?
Not really.
Look, there is no real damage done. Only one British guy has read the thing. What else is gonna see it? You're gonna be okay.
Yeah.
I'll come back later. You're safe.
Oh, Sheridan Press wants to publish your journal? Wow, that's big.
Yeah.
You look like somebody just died.
Yeah.
Okay, it was a shitty thing for her to do, and I'm not standing up for her or anything, but ultimately, isn't it excellent that someone, they think you wrote something good and they want to publish you?
How can I publish it? It is my personal life. You know? What will people think? And the writing, it has no structure, you know? It's crap.
I doubt it. What's really bothering you? Is it you think what you wrote is crap? Or you're afraid what people will think?
Both, maybe.
Well, all artists feel that way. And ultimately, it's not for you to decide whether it's good or bad, your job is to be honest and put it out there. Mm-hmm. Besides, this is every writer's wet dream. Someone wants to publish you.
Yeah, but I was gonna write the great American novel.
Ooh.
You know, these are romance or
something. What's the worst that could happen?
I don't know. You know, it flops.
Thus, no one will have read it.
Oh, well, then my mother disowns me for being a pervert. Some right-wing lunatic comes and kills me in my sleep. Doubtful.
I don't know exactly. Maybe you're afraid of people finding out who you are. Is that who I am? It's your journal.
Yeah, but what if people hate it?
They hate me. And they don't know the real you. Besides, you can't please everybody.
Oh, why not?
Seems to me you have two choices. You can bury your head in the sand, or you can put yourself out there and deal with whatever happens.
Oh.
Whatever happens.
Yep. Welcome back. Under better circumstance, I hope.
Yes.
No screaming boyfriends following you today.
No. I'm all by myself today, thanks.
Oh, well, great. Alex is finishing up a meeting. Why don't you want to have a seat? Do you want some coffee or something?
Oh, no, I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay. That's the writer. If you want to talk to her, now's your chance.
You're Beth Moss, right?
Right.
Yeah, I'm Erica. I'm one of the editor authors readers here.
Oh no. You didn't read.
Oh no, I'm really no. It's all fine, really. I'm sorry about that whole little misunderstanding. But I did want to say that I read your manuscript and I really, really loved it. It was amazing, truly. I was blown away, and I know that this is going to sound kind of silly, but it changed my life.
It changed your life?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Whew. It was just liberating. But I thought it was fiction, and it rocked my world. And then when I found out it was real, I mean, I can't tell you how much it rocked my world. And I'm sorry.
No.
I wanted to thank you.
I don't know what to say.
Oh, that's, you know, okay. I just thought it was important to tell you.
Thank you.
Ah, ready for an expensive lunch on me?
It was really nice to meet you.
Thank you. The pleasure was all mine.
So, how'd it go? Were they really disappointed?
No, they were really happy. He thinks he needs a lot of editing, and I made a promise we'll be publishing his fiction, you know, change all the names and stuff like that.
What'd you say?
I'm gonna publish it!
We went over this.
No.
You were going to keep it private.
Yeah, I know, but I was thinking about it, and you know, what is the worst that happens? You know, nobody reads it, right?
Look, Beth, you can't do this.
Oh, I think I'm doing the right thing.
No, no,
you know?
Look, people are going to know that's you and me.
No, they won't. It'll be fiction. Your name won't even be in it.
Don't you get it? You're the writer. People are gonna know, my friends will know, whether it's fiction or not, they're gonna know you're into this stuff.
Oh, I know.
I'm your boyfriend. If you're into it, they're gonna think I am.
Well, you are.
No, not like that. It is one thing in our private life, it's another to put it out there for everyone to see. It's like we're having sex in public.
No, I can't get arrested for writing a book.
But this isn't funny.
Look, I'm sorry. You know, but I've been thinking about this, and I was going to go in there today, and I was going to tell him no. You know, and then this girl that I have never even met before told me that I had changed her life. You know, just by sharing myself, really. And it occurred to me, you know, what if that is what I have to offer?
Beth,
what if that is enough?
Beth, this isn't who you are, okay? It's just something we do sometimes.
No, it's not a phase.
But it is not who you are.
Well, I think my journal expresses who I am pretty clearly. You know, that includes my experiences with spanking and bisexuality.
You're bisexual.
And I feel stronger and healthier and more creative and more sexual than I ever have before. You know, you've been happy too, right? Thought you were.
You slept with her.
Yes.
While we were together.
Yes.
Anyone else you slept with that you want to share with me?
Evan, I'm so sorry. I didn't know how to tell you. You hated her so much.
You think it's okay to sleep with people who I like? That's the deciding factor? I like Jake Rubin a lot. Why not sleep with him? Beth, that was a joke. Oh, my God. I don't know you at all. So this is the new you, huh? The person that you like so much?
I'm sorry, I should have talked to you about it.
Yeah, well, it's a little late now. Look, I'm really glad that you have found yourself and that you're strong and happy, but if you think that I am going to go along with this, then you are insane. And if you really are going to publish that work of fiction, then I hope that you will have the decency to leave me out of it. And just for the record, no, I don't like it.
I deserve that. I know. I should have told him, but I guess I rationalized it by figuring that since Mina was out of my life, it wasn't important to tell him anymore. That's never a good way to behave in a relationship. Keeping secrets. What am I going to do? There's one thing I'm sure of, though. I'm not going to run and hide. I'm going to do what I think is right. I'm going to put it out there and deal with whatever happens.
Hi, Beth. Look, I know you don't want to talk to me, but I just wanted to call you again and tell you how sorry I am. And if there's anything I can do to make it up to you, I really would like to. So, call me if you feel like it, and, anyway, I hope everything's going well for you. Bye.
Oh no, more champagne! We must have more champagne!
I hope there's some more back here.
I will.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
And happy new year.
I had to drop off some things for Jake. You want my favorite maple squeeze.
You're
welcome. You know, in this case, I've got the mock-up for Beth's new book cover.
Sure.
What are you thinking of? Stuck in here.
Oh, wow. She wants to use that?
Yeah, well, we'll get the new.
Oh, you need Jake's.
Oh, you think I'm a complete wanker, do you?
Okay, oh, so you already have Jake's.
Yeah, carte blanche or anything I wanted to use. I just thought it would be his thoughts. And it's fine with you, then?
Yeah, absolutely.
Fabulous. Well, then, if that's the case, I will make sure to draw some paperwork for you. Just sign it, get it back to me, and then you know. Beth's birthday is coming up.
Yeah. I thought maybe I would get her one of those peace offering birthday gifts. You got any suggestions?
Well, she's pretty handy with a flogger. Oh, another one of those would be fantastic.
This is for her, not for you.
It'll be for both.
So, how is she doing?
Oh, she's doing quite well, actually. You know, in fact, I think she's blossoming. She and, what's his thing that broke up?
That was bound to happen.
Yeah, well, I'm just glad it happened sooner rather than later.
So, is there something going on there?
I don't know. She's got many admirers. I'm just happy enough to be in the inner circle.
Oh, that's a nice place to be.
You should call her when it's her birthday wishes.
I've called. She doesn't pick up.
Never give up.
Never surrender.
Happy New Year, darling.
Happy New Year.
So I'm published! I feel like at this point I should have something really profound to say. You know, something that sums up all of my experiences in an insightful and interesting soundbite. But I've got nothing. Maybe Mina was right. You know, maybe it's important to just relax and breathe. But if I was going to sum it up, I might say, take big risks, whether you think they're going to pay off or not.
Just breathe deep and dive in.
Where are we going?
It's a surprise. Now close your eyes.
I hate surprises.
Okay, open it.
It's a book.
It's Beth's book.
Yeah, I know. I read the original. Why give me this?
I thought you might like to get it autographed.
Oh, no. I am not going to her book signing.
Oh, yes, you are. But first, you're going to read something.
She dedicated it?
To you.
From myself, I am copper. To you, friend, I am gold. From myself, I am stone.
Through you, I am a gem.
That is a lovely dedication by the 18th century poet Rumi. And now I think we have time for a few questions, if there are any questions. Yes, you in the glasses.
I hope this question isn't out of line, but is the main character in your book based on you?
Yes, it is.
So does that make you a professional dominatrix?
No, I'm strictly amateur.
Yes.
Do you take classes or know someone who does?
Actually, we talked about this earlier, and I could give a demonstration if you like.
But I'm going to need a volunteer.
I've got a volunteer for you right here.
Did you plan this with her?
Would I do a thing like that?
Come on, hurry it up!
I'm going to get you both for this.
Promises, promises.
I would like to take a poll. This woman gave her best friend's journal to a perfect stranger and didn't ask permission. Would you say she deserves a spank?
Oh, yeah.
Oh my God,
well,
please spank me!
Thank you.